Hey guys, what's up? It's Charlie here, and today we're going to be looking at what will happen in the next 10 billion years. People move so fast, we can barely think about what's going to happen tomorrow. But let's get existential for a while and think about the next 10 billion years. What languages will we speak? What will people look like? Will we have colonized Mars or made alien contact? Or will the world even be here? These are all questions that will be answered. Before we get into it, why not subscribe and press the notification bell too? Or if you don't have time now, do it in the next 10 billion years. So first off, where am I getting this information? Well, a few years back, the BBC made something called the Timeline of the Far Future. This is a timeline of Earth from now to 10 billion years in the future. So let's get into some of the major events which will be happening from now to 10 billion years in the future. So first off, let's look at 1,000 years away from right now. That sounds like a lot, but in the grand scheme of things, it really isn't. In 1,000 years, buildings will have all naturally decayed as they are now. Of course, these will likely be rebuilt sooner than 1,000 years in the future. But any of your favorite historic monuments still standing today likely will not be around. Not only that, you won't be able to speak to anyone in 1,000 years. Not just because you won't be alive, but because you won't speak their language. In 1,000 years, language will have developed so much they won't have any words left over from now. Now what about 2,000 years in the future? Well, in 2,000 years, most of the ice will have melted in Greenland. Despite their names, Iceland is known for greenery and Greenland is known for ice. But by the year 4000, all of Greenland's ice will have melted. Now let's fast forward to 10,000 years in the future. 10,000 years in the future, 89% of all the carbon dioxide we have right now will be gone. Not only that, the tilt of the Earth's axles will have reversed. This will expose us more to the Sun and Jupiter. And this may cause very extreme weather for most of the world. This can be things like tsunamis, tornadoes, and hurricanes. On a lighter note, 20,000 years in the future, Chernobyl will finally be safe. That's right, over 20,000 years after the Chernobyl disaster, it will finally be safe. In case you guys don't know, Chernobyl is a massive nuclear accident that happened in 1986. It took place in Pripyat, Ukraine. The ginormous nuclear power plant explosion took 31 lives and it's still not safe today. But 20,000 years in the future, it will be. Now let's move forward to 50,000 years in the future. In 50,000 years, Niagara Falls will have disappeared. The remainder of Lake Erie will have dissolved naturally over time. And because of this, the waterfall and amazing tourist attraction will not exist. This is very sad as it's such a beautiful sight to see. But don't worry, you have 50,000 years to experience it. If you're too lazy to go there in 50,000 years, then it's your own fault. Okay, so we've seen 50,000 years in the future, but let's go over to 100,000 years. In 100,000 years, you will not be able to watch this video if you have a MacBook. That is because MacBooks will start dissolving in 100,000 years. The titanium in your MacBook will begin to corrode naturally. But don't worry, you'll likely have got a virus or two before that happens. Also in 100,000 years, the stars will look very different. All constellations we know nowadays will cease to exist. Instead, star watchers will look at all new constellations in the galaxy. This is not only because some stars will disappear and others will be born, it's also because Earth will move around the galaxy. Another thing that will happen in the galaxy in 100,000 years is a supernova near to Earth. This will be a massive supernova in space. What is now the VY Canis Majoris will explode into a supernova visible from Earth. But most scarily, there will be a global disaster in 100,000 years. That is because by then a supervolcano will have erupted on Earth. This is very concerning and may wipe out a lot of life. Now let's fast forward to 500,000 years and things don't get any more calm. The Earth is actually struck by a ginormous asteroid. The asteroid will be around 1 kilometer and will destroy a lot of Earth. And in 500,000 years, there may even be a new ice age. And I don't mean a new installation to the movie franchise. I mean the world will literally freeze over in a real-life ice age. Then, in a million years, all monuments known today will be gone. The man-made monuments will have gone long ago, but even the natural ones will now likely be gone. Only things like Mount Rushmore and the Pyramids of Giza will still be around. Everything else will be totally wiped out and eroded. Also in a million years, all glass we have today will have decomposed. Now let's go over to 5 million years in the future. If you're a man watching this 5 million years in the future, well, you won't be. That is because in 5 million years, men will be extinct. And when I say men, I don't mean mankind. Women are actually safe. The Y chromosome will actually have crumpled by that point, making men impossible. This literally means men will go extinct long before women do. And you know how I said in a million years Mount Rushmore will still be one of the only monuments still around? Well, in 7.5 million years, Mount Rushmore will have finally eroded. Let's look at 10 million years in the future now. 10 million years in the future, a new ocean will have formed. The Red Sea will have risen and flooded, which will divide the continent of Africa. This will create a new massive ocean. But as this new ocean is formed, 40 million years after that, the Mediterranean will be gone. Africa will have floated away and collided with the Mediterranean, sealing it off. Not only that, in 50 million years, the Antarctica ice will have melted. This will have raised the sea level by 75 meters. But something cool will be happening in space in 50 million years. There will be the possibility of a galactic empire. 50 million years is the time it will take for the entire galaxy to be colonized. So even if things are getting too wild on Earth, maybe we'll be on another planet. And that's a good thing, because in 60 million years, Earth's orbit will be unpredictable. The effects of gravity will multiply, and this could make orbit very scary. The Earth may rapidly spin around, and we will notice it. We know the Earth is spinning right now, but it goes so fast we don't realize. But this may make things unpredictable, and the Earth will shake like crazy. And while we're in a dark mood, let's go over to 2.8 billion years. In 2.8 billion years, there will be the end of all life on Earth. And I don't just mean human life, I mean any animals, organisms, or anything. The reason why is because the Earth will be around 150 degrees Celsius. That's over 300 degrees Fahrenheit. In 20 billion years, there's something called the Big Rip. This will be an expansion in the universe which could tear all matter apart. All distances will now become infinite, and this could end the entire universe. In 100 billion years, there'll be a group merge of all the galaxies. That's right, all the galaxies nearest to our galaxy will begin to merge together. Now, this begins in 100 billion years, but the process could take over 1 trillion years. Also in 1 trillion years, there won't be any stars left. Galaxies will have lost all of their gas clouds, so they won't be able to make any new stars. And 10 trillion years after that, 110 trillion years away, all stars existing will be gone. All stars will have burnt out and will have become black holes. Then, in 100 quintillion years, the Earth will finally cease to exist completely. We all know it will be a big burning planet with nothing on it anyway. But in 100 quintillion years, it will finally decay and go into the sun. So guys, that's what will happen and how the world will end. Unlike what the movies say, it's not going to be some massive hurricane or tsunami. It's also not going to be some kind of world war or politician like the newspapers say. So guys, remember, whatever happens in the world, try not to worry too much. I hope this video hasn't filled you with that much dread. I know it kind of has for me, and I really need to take a sit down after recording this. But it is still pretty fascinating to find out what will happen all of these years from now. And it really puts things into perspective, guys. Whatever's going on now, it's not that big of a problem in the grand scheme of things. So try not to worry and just enjoy life while you still have it. And of course, while the Earth hasn't yet plunged into the sun. But now guys, here's a question for you. Would you rather pass away like a normal human being? Or would you want to go on living forever and never pass away? Vote in the poll in the top right corner, and I'll be really interested to see the results. But as always, thank you guys for watching. Check out some more videos on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.